It is higher than the mountains that I face. It is stronger than the power of the grave. It is constant in the trial and the change. This one thing remains. This one thing remains. Out on me. Your love never fails and never gives up. It never runs out on me. Your love never fails and never gives up. It never runs out on me. Your love. It never runs out on me. Your love never fails and never gives up. It never runs out on me. Your love never fails and never gives up. It never runs out on me.
Lord, we will wait upon. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul, worship His holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul, I'll worship Your holy name.
Bless the Lord.
my time has come. Still my soul will sing your praise unending. 10,000 years and then forevermore.
Forevermore.
Before the scripture reading, ooh, that's really loud, I want to invite up Bill Eldridge from Council to speak to you for a moment.
All right, thanks, Pastor Becky, appreciate that. As many of you already know, Calvary Lutheran has kicked off its 2019 stewardship campaign, and I just wanted to take a minute or two to talk a little bit about that campaign. Now, there are many, many reasons to give regularly to the church, and I could think of two of them that are important to me. And the first one I learned from a story I heard about a guy who, after hearing a sermon series from the book of Matthew on storing up your treasures in heaven, he asked his family that after he died, he wanted them to sell all his possessions, buy as many gold bricks as possible with the money, fill a suitcase with that gold, and bury it with him. So after the man passes away, his family did exactly that, and they filled a suitcase with gold bricks and set the suitcase in his coffin. Well, when the man reached the gates of heaven, he met St. Peter there, and St. Peter asked him, hey, what's in the suitcase? And the man opened the suitcase very proudly and showed the gold bricks to St. Peter, and St. Peter smiled and said, oh, great, you brought street pavement. So the point of the story is not to give to the church because you cannot take it with you. Although if that works for you and that's your motivation, you know, please go for it. But instead, the point is that our treasures cannot be stored in heaven after we get there. But we begin to store our treasures in heaven right now by how we serve God and how we demonstrate our love for our neighbors. So reason number one to give regularly to the church is that your money is worth a lot more on earth now than it will be worth when you get to heaven. So as many of you may have heard, and there are handouts available in the church about this year's stewardship campaign, the campaign is called To Reach for the Possibilities, and it focuses on supporting outreach ministries with technology that Pastor David talked about last week, bolstering our middle school ministries, investing in small group ministries, and supporting the church's future with investments in the building and in staff. And you can invest in these ministries through regular giving with a pledge card that you'll probably be receiving in the mail or that will be available in the church in the coming weeks. Now, the second reason to give regularly to the church, I learned while watching our confirmation group at this last weekend at Outlaw Ranch. And during that weekend, one of the things that we did was to brainstorm service project ideas for our small groups. And what amazed me the most about our small group is that nearly every one of the ideas that they came up with were projects to serve the church and to make the church better. So some of the ideas that they thought of included building bigger communion kits to take to our growing congregation that worships with us through live streaming. Another one was to sponsor a trunk at Trunk or Treat, or to raise money for other church ministries, or to help fix up the church or paint the church. So what made me really proud of these students is what they wanted to spend their time, their creativity, and their talents on making our church better. And at their age, they don't have a lot of money to do that, but they do have the heart and the time to give. So the second reason to give regularly to the church is to secure the church's future and these kids' future in the church. So let's make sure that our future generations continue to have a wonderful building, a great staff, and talented pastors to keep them connected to God and to grow their love for the church and for their neighbors. Thank you very much.
Our scripture reading from tonight is from 1 Timothy chapter 6. For the love of money is a root of all kinds of evil, and in their eagerness to be rich, some have wandered away from the faith and pierced themselves with many pains. As for those who in the present age are rich, command them not to be haughty or to set their hopes on the uncertainty of riches, but rather on God, who richly provides us with everything for our enjoyment. They are to do good, to be rich in good works, generous, and ready to share, thus storing up for themselves the treasure of a good foundation for the future, so that they may take hold of the life that really is life. Here ends our reading. Tonight is a night that we have the puppets. So we need a little help so they know we're ready. On the count of three, we'll say, puppets, come out. One, two, three.
Hello, Snickers. You don't look so good.
I am not.
Well, what is wrong?
I was trying to be a better monster.
Well, what's the problem?
It is not working.
What do you mean?
I just don't feel like being better.
Tell me more.
I want to be nice, but I don't always feel like it.
Okay.
And I want to share more, but I don't always feel like sharing.
Okay.
And I want to be more loving, but I don't always feel like loving.
Why don't you just try to act like it?
What?
If you act nice, you might start to feel like being nice.
Really?
If you just share more, you might start to feel like sharing.
That would be cool.
And if you just act more loving, you might feel more loving.
Okay, I get it. If we go through the action, we might change our hearts.
Yes.
I think I will go help Benny, even if I don't want to.
Sounds like a good idea.
And I will share my liverwurst and onion sandwich even when I want to keep it to myself.
Sounds like a great idea.
And I will treat everybody the best I can, and I might just start to be more loving.
Okay, now you're getting it, but let's get back to sharing that liverwurst and onion sandwich.
I take it you want half of it?
Yes, I do.
Well, let's go and share it.
Sounds great. Goodbye, everyone.
Yeah, and have a great week.
You know, you can change a lot with just 46 characters. For example, you can change where you live. Or you could change your relationship status. Fellas, we do not recommend proposing via text message. You could also change your career, change your vehicle, or you could change just about anything. But maybe this week, you could use 46 characters to change someone's life. think about it, pray about it, and use your 46 characters for a change.
Let's pray. Lord God, may the words of my mouth, the meditation of our hearts and minds, be acceptable unto you, our rock and our redeemer. Amen. Have you ever thought about that just a few words that you have to say could change somebody's life? It really doesn't take much, but it can change a perspective and turn everything around. It can be the same sometimes when you're reading the Bible. It could be just a few words, like in 1 Timothy, and all of a sudden, you have this change. Your focus and your perspective becomes different. It might be, whoa, I was so caught up in these things that I wanted to get. And then I read that text, and I realized, oh, maybe I should focus on God. Maybe I should focus on my neighbor and connect with those around me instead of worrying about the things that I want to collect. But the things that we have, our money and our time and our materials and our words, can be used to make community greater. Now, Sarah, that's not her real name. She's a typical teenager. At least she wants to be a typical teenager. But there were a few words that she heard from her doctor that changed her life. Just a few words. You have cancer. And suddenly, her being a typical teen wasn't so typical anymore. She still wanted to do what every other teen did, but her perspective changed right away. And she came home from school one day and told her mom, you know what? I think I want to call all my friends and just tell them how much I appreciate them. Let them know about the important times that we had together, because I want to do it now while I'm feeling good. Could you imagine as a mom having your teen come home and tell you that? And yet for her, her perspective had changed, and suddenly those connections, those people in her life were so important that she couldn't wait another moment. She wanted to use her words to tell them about it. Now, Pastor David meets with a couple other men a couple times on Saturday mornings a month, and they talk about the Bible together, ask questions, have conversation, think about their faith. I'm not sure exactly what they talk about. All that I know when he comes back is that I can tell that he's connected with a couple other men, that they have had that time together in the busyness of life to set aside some Saturdays just to talk about what faith means. What could they learn that they read in the Bible that helps them in their lives today? Just a simple connection. Now, as a pastor, your pastors in the Lutheran churches, ELCA, and your rostered leaders like Tom, Deacon Tom, we gather once a month as well. We meet to learn, to catch up, to hear what's happening. We worship together, and we pray together. In the last month that we met, we worshiped at Trinity Lutheran. They were hosting in their eco park, so outside. So we were gathered in that space, worshiping, while traffic is going by, and I never realized how noisy it was down there. And I had to laugh a little bit because we're singing a song together, and here's this big vehicle going by, really slow, really loud, and you could see the person just watching us. What are they doing over there? We were worshiping together, and we take time to pray. When somebody has something going on in their lives, we like to surround them and take a moment to pray. Again, there could be things that we do on those busy Tuesday mornings, but it always feels good to come together, to connect, to use our words to build one another up. Confirmation, they meet in these small groups. And we were just talking as the adults, like, it seems like the time goes by so fast. Like, there's so much to cover. What if we don't cover all of it? And yet, they meet together. They connect. They get to talk about life. They pray for each other. And they create community. Sometimes it simply takes just a few words. just a few things that we can do with what we have to draw closer to God and to draw closer to one another. It's not that what 1 Timothy talks about, that those other things are horrible and you must stay away from them. Because in 1 Timothy, it didn't say, the root of all evil is money. Money is evil, and everything evil comes from that. It actually says, a root of all kinds of evil. There's all different things that draw us away from God and from each other. Money can be used to do good things as well. Anything that takes away our focus on God and upon somebody else can turn into something bad. But it also can be used for something good. Just a few words can change our perspective, can change how we see being about community. And when we use what we have for community, we build a greater, abundant life, that life that God wants for each one of us. Now, I'm thankful for Bill Eldridge, who came forward to speak to you about our stewardship initiative, because one of those, you'll get that flyer handed out today, is about small groups for adults. Because the leadership at the congregation thinks it's so important for people to connect with one another, to gather together, to build one another up through meeting together, maybe through service, that we'd like to make that one of our initiatives. Because everybody has this need to connect, to be seen, to be heard, to be known. And that's what that initiative is about. So I hope that you think about, deep down, what is your desire, your need to be seen, to be heard, to be known? What do you need as an individual in order to connect with others, to create community? And are you willing to be a part of that active activity to make that happen so that we can draw together as a community? We can use our money and our things to make community. We can use our words to connect with one another. Because when we do that, when we don't just think about ourselves, I want this for me, 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 we turn me into we. And when we have we end up having community with one another. So I pray that you may be connected because you are God's beloved children, and together we create abundant life. Amen.
Healing rain is coming down. It's coming nearer to this old town. Rich and poor, weak and strong, it's bringing mercy. It won't be long. Healing rain is coming down. It's coming closer to the lost and found. Tears of joy and tears of shame are washed forever in Jesus' name. Healing rain, it comes with fire, so let it fall and take us higher. In heaven's
your hands. Let us return to the mercy seat where time began. And in your eyes I see the pain. Come soak this dry heart with healing rain. Only you, the Son of Man, can take a leper and let him stand. So lift your hands, they can be held by someone greater, the great I am. Healing rain, it comes with fire, so let it fall and take us higher. This healing rain,
night I got to hang out with all the sixth graders, and the sixth graders, their milestone is the image of God, and each one of them is getting a mirror to hang in their lockers. And one of the things that we hope that they'll do is when they look in the locker, not just see if their hair is out of place or their shirt's right or they make sure they didn't leave any food from lunch, but that they look at themselves and see what really is good about them. They got a chance to hear what they like about themselves and what their parents love about them. Sometimes it's easy for us to only focus on what's not working. And sometimes we need to focus on what is working in this world. Each one of these is a precious child of God. They were created in the image of God, and they're wonderful. And I hope that each one of them knows that. So I'm going to ask you to join with me and pray for them. And it's a repeat after me, so I know you can do it. Dear God, thank you for each of these sixth graders. Thank you for how awesome they are. The gifts that they have. The love that they share. Help them
to know how awesome they are. And drowned out those negative sounds. Amen.
Amen.
All right. Parents, kids, face each other. Parents, if you would repeat after me. You are definitely a child of God. I love you. And so does God, and make the sign of the cross. All right, same thing. Say it to your parents. You are definitely a child of God. I love you, and so does God. And make the sign of the cross. Give them a round of applause. And you can go on back. Let us pray. Gracious and ever-living God, we thank you for all your blessings. We thank you for all the youth. May you continue to strengthen them each day. And may they know your love, no matter how dark things sometimes get. Lord, be with those who are hurting in mind, body, and spirit. The names we know and the names we don't. We especially pray for the Liz Good family as she passed away yesterday. And wherever kids or adults or anyone is hurting. Lord, we pray this in your name. Amen. Now let us pray the words our Savior continues to teach us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Please stand and join with me in singing All the People Say Amen.
Yeah.
welcome and inspire all with grace, courage, and love. Reach up, reach in, reach out.
It's who I am, it's who I am.